welcome back to the channel. Join me here at Taswood Fishery again on Heron Lake. So we're going to go for a walk around now, see if we can find some fish holding up anywhere, any kind of shows, and we'll get set up on them, see if we can catch a carp. But let's go for a look around before the rain comes and get set up. Well guys, just before I get the rod out, I'd just like to show you a new product that I've got from Parker Baits, which is the baiter pole. Absolutely awesome bit of kit, well made. As you can see, it's got these sections that you just clip in as you go, just a thumb button sort of thing. You click it in and next section as you go, as many as you need. I think it comes with 20 of these standard. Obviously your baiter pole, but it's a devastating bit of kit. I'm sure you've all seen similar products, and what it allows you to do is be stealthy. You can be quiet, fish up the margin. I mean, if you see bubblers out there, carp absolutely fizzing up, it allows you to just ship this out and just plop a bait straight on the carp's head, and it really, really is devastating. I've seen so many videos of people catching carp in seconds using one of these, and yeah, I'm gonna get on it. It's my first time using it as well, so yeah, I'm gonna get the rig in, get some bait in, and we'll ship it out. There you go guys, as you can see, I'm shipping her out. What I'll do is grab each section as I need it. Well, there we go guys, that's the proof in the pudding. That baiter pole couldn't have been out, hadn't dropped that bait no longer than 3 minutes. And it roared off. I'm sorry, I didn't have the GoPro on, I'm still getting the rods out. But that's how effective the baiter pole can really be. When it was out there, 2-3 minutes, they'd gone with this lovely little ghostie. Not gonna weigh her, probably 11, 12 pounds, something like that. That's a start. Hopefully that's a sign of a lot more to come. Let's get her back. Well, I just thought I'd give you an update from the fish we had. It's been a few hours since I had that fish, and I've not seen anything to go on. Before I set up in here, I saw some swells at the back there, which is the only thing I saw, which is why I set up here. And as you saw, the bite was very quick. I didn't even get the second rod out. And the first one was away, didn't have the GoPro on or anything. But I've had a few liners since then. Hopefully we've got a couple of nights, so I'm sure we'll have another one. But yeah, time's getting on now. It's about 7 o'clock, so I'm gonna think about redoing the rods and getting some food on. But if I don't check in with you before then, I'll check in with you in the morning, and hopefully you'll see us with a carp. Well, it's the morning after that fish now, and I've got some bad news. I lost a couple of fish in the night. One early on in the night, rod absolutely melted off, picked up into it, and there was nothing there, so I don't know whether that was a trailer or if I'm being done. I had one snap me off, and then lost one first thing this morning as well, so that's three. So I might shorten the length of the hook link, maybe try a different pattern of hook. I do have confidence in the rig I'm using, and I don't usually lose fish like that, which is making me think that maybe I'm not being done, that there may be a trailer, I don't know. I may just change the length of the hook link to begin with and see if that works. But I think for now, the wind is absolutely hacking down into this corner, so I've seen a few fish jump out in open water, so I'm going to move my right hand rods into open water and see if we can't catch one of them, because I've seen about 3 or 4 jump out there. So yeah, I'm going to bring that rod in and I'm going to prepare some more bait because I need a little bit more made up, and I'll run you through how I'm using that and why I'm using it the way I am, and then I'll run you through the rigs. So we're going to get the rest of this bait prepared now for today and tomorrow, and we're going to start off. I've got some mixed boilies in there, fruit and nut and OG fish. That's a kilo, so it's 1/2 kilo of each. I'm just going to stick that straight in the bucket. And on top of that, I'm going to go in with some chops, which looks like this. Now what this does is just small little particles, some bigger bits in there. That keeps the fish just grubbing around that little bit longer, and hopefully hold them there a bit longer as well, which is exactly what we want. So I'm going to put a bit of that in, and then I'm going to put some of the OG fish hemp oil in there. Go heavy with that. And then to top it off, the OG fish fruit and nut sauce. I'm going to go heavy with that as well. And then we're just going to give that a mix around. Magic dust sprinkled all over the top. You'll end up with something like this. What that's going to do is just keep them, there's so many different little food particles in there, that's going to keep them grubbing around for that bit longer and hopefully do us a couple more bites. So I'm going to get this out, as I said, bring the right hand rod in, get that out in open water. See if we can't catch a carp. Come off of the open water spot where I changed the hook length, shortened it a little bit, and obviously moved out into the open water. I've had this one. It's always nice to know that you've got two spots that are doing bites, so that gives you absolute confidence. And yeah, hopefully there's a couple more to come, but if not, I'm very happy. I'll show you the other side and we're getting back. Probably mid double, something like that. The rain's now about to come, so yeah, let's get him back. Well, here we go. Just before I ship this rod out with the pole, I thought I'd just show you. And it's simple stuff again, tubing, lead clip, 3 ounce dumpy pair, and this is the hook link I'd shortened. I went longer because I was fishing silt and I thought I might be plugging in, but it turns out I weren't. And when you're shipping the rig out with the baiting pole, it's such a soft drop anyway that it doesn't really matter too much, so I've shortened that. And yeah, it's done the bite. It's just got a pineapple pop up on there. That's what's doing the do. All right, there we go, guys. A small one early into the night. And, happy with that, but I'm probably not going to put that rod out. I've started feeling a bit unwell, and I'm going to leave first thing in the morning. So I'm getting back and getting bed. Well, a little update. This morning now. And I don't know what happened last night. Well, I felt so rough. I felt extremely ill. And you can probably hear from my voice, I'm still a bit ill now. I was gonna go home. I've got the rest of the day to go, but I might stay a few hours. So we get on, because I feel a bit better. But I'll show you the spots I was fishing that's done me the bites, because I've swapped and changed a couple of spots. I'll just show you them. So the first spot that done me the ghosty was down here when I was shipped out with the pole. And then the one I put in open water about halfway out there. And then I saw a fish jump at this bridge. And I put one on the corner out, that done me a couple of fish. And yeah, I put one back over there this morning. And one out in open water. But I did have a couple of fish in the night as well, which I didn't film. So I felt rough. I literally just unhooked them in the net and let them back. So I've had 5, lost 3. So hopefully we can get one more for the camera to show you. If not, I'm happy with what I've had. It's been a good little session. But yeah, hopefully I'm slowly packing down. I'm gonna stay a little while longer. Sort of getting everything ready. Let's just see if we can get one more for the camera. I'll catch in with you in a bit. Well, unfortunately, that's our time over now here at Taswood Lake on Heron Lake here. I've really enjoyed myself, had a few fish, nothing big, but we can't choose what picks up the hook bait. But yeah, we'll be back soon. And if you've enjoyed the video, make sure you subscribe, leave us a thumbs up, and leave a comment. And until the next one, tight lines and be lucky.